Assalamu alaikum, dear students. This is Shagufta Khurram after a few days and from Department of English with the course American Drama EG614. This is lecture number 4 and the topic is the zoo story. The zoo story, I have already given you a PDF file to read out the play, as this is the last play of the course, and as we finish this play then the course will be completed. So let's discuss the few topics in lecture number 4 about the zoo story. This is the image of Peter and Jerry, the two focusing major highlighted characters in the play, the zoo story. You can see they are discussing to each other. What we are supposed to do here, the contents of this play are introduction to the playwright, introduction to the play, characters in the play, summary of the play, themes in the play, analysis of the play, questions to write the answers. In lecture number 4, we are going to talk about introduction to the playwright, introduction to the play, and characters in the play. In next lecture, we will discuss about summary of the play and themes of the play, and in the last lecture we will talk about analysis of the play and questions to write the answers. Introduction to the playwright, Edward Albee. Edward Albee is very much famous. He is contemporary writer of Eugene O'Neill and Arthur Miller as well. He has big name, very famous American dramatist. He was born, full name was Edward Franklin Albee III. He was born on 12 March 1928, Virginia, U.S., died September 16, 2016. He remained for the age of 88 years. Montauk, New York, U.S., his occupation, what he was doing, his occupation was he was a dramatist. And nationality was American, American dramatist. So he had the age, as I have given the period of 1958 to 2016. That was a nationality period of Edward Albee. If we talk about 1958, that was his first year, and in this year he wrote this play as well, The Zoo Story, and this is the first play of the writer, which gave him great popularity in the society. His noble works are Who is Afraid of Regina Wolf, The Zoo Story, A Delicate Balance, The God or Who is Slavia, Three Tall Women, and Nobel Awards, which he got throughout his career. They are Pulitzer Prize for Drama, Tony Edward Prize for the Best Play, National Medal of Arts, Special Tony Award, American Award in Literature, Partner Jonathan Thomas. So you can see that he has got number of the awards and he has done a lot of work in literature. So this is a little introduction about playwright Edward Albee. Now let's discuss introduction to the play The Zoo Story. Actually, The Zoo Story is one act play, and this is written by very famous American dramatist Edward Albee. This is only one act play. There is only one act, and major two characters are there, Peter and Jerry. We are coming later on the characters. Let's discuss about the description of the play, The Zoo Story. The Zoo Story is a one act play by American playwright Edward Albee. This was his first play, and it was written in 1958 and completed in just 3 weeks. Yes, this was told by Edward Albee that I sat for 3 weeks and I completed this play. The play explores the themes of isolation, loneliness, miscommunication, as anthemization and social disparity and dehumanization in a materialistic world. Actually, you know that the Second World War affected a lot on the minds of the people, and especially in America, we have already discussed the three plays where we discuss about these themes as well. But this play is full of absurdity. The major theme of this play is absurdity. So absurdity also covers loneliness, isolation, etc. The play was first performed on 28 September 1959, and this genre of this play is one act play. Now let's talk about the characters of the play. Actually, in the zoo story, there are only two characters, which are the major characters. The supporting are some other, we will talk later on supporting characters, but the whole play is revolving around these two characters, Peter and Jerry. Now let's see who is Peter and who is Jerry. Peter is an executive for a publishing house. He is having an executive job in a publishing house. He is an average size and nearsighted man in his early 40s. His age is early 40s, maybe 40, maybe 41. Peter has catholic tastes and dresses conservatively, and he is an upper class representative of the Eisenhower years. Actually, these two characters are highlighted in the play by Edward Albee. One is representing the upper class of the society, and other is representing the lower class of the society. So middle class is also discussed over there. So Peter is the representative of upper class. So when there was the upper class, what the people used to do, they used to keep the pets as well at their homes. So furthermore, the details of Peter's family is, his family life is predictably normal. He has a good wife, has two daughters, two cats, two parakeets, and a nice apartment in the East 70s of Manhattan. Actually, this shows that the upper class of that society. His attitude reflects his status. He had some attitude, like the people who belong to upper class, they show the attitude. He is naive, complacent, passive, proper, and a bit bored. His intention on this afternoon was to read quietly in Central Park. Actually, it was a holiday, and he went in Central Park by having a book in his hand that he will sit over there on a bench and will read the book. So he had the intention to read the book silently in the Central Park. So while he was reading, a stranger named Jerry interrupts him with talk, and then he aggression. Actually, if you have read the play, you had seen that the first sentence which he talks, that I had been in the zoo, and this he is repeating. He is saying again and again. Jerry is telling Peter that I have been in the zoo, I have been in the zoo. So this way he was making Peter irritated. Although Peter is slow to anger, Jerry's incessant prodding eventually drives him to pick up the Jerry's knife. Yes, Jerry had a knife with him. So in the end, you will find that the Peter picks up the knife, but he does not kill the Jerry. You will come to know in the end that the Jerry himself kills. He committed suicide. That will be discussed later in the summary. Okay. After Jerry impales himself, Peter exits the now ending play, and his previously established character, destroyed by this chance and absurd encounter. So this is the character of Peter, that the an executive person having the age of early 40s, and he is actually representing the upper class of the society. It shows the different sort of the things, like the pets, and he had a good wife and two daughters, and he lives a happy life. In other character, very important character, is antagonist of the play, Jerry. Jerry is actually an emotionally disturbed man in his late 30s. His age was late 30s. Anxious and angry about his bisexuality. Actually, he was a homosexual person as well, as the other characters were shown in other plays, that the homosexuality was also the major issue of that society. So he had the poverty and alienation. Jerry tries to make sense of his pain by walking from New York Zoo looking for another human to confront. Actually, here Edward Albee shows that the lower class person, the middle class person, wants somebody to listen that person. Actually, he was finding someone who may listen him, who may listen his pains of the life, miseries of the life. So he was looking for the person. That's why he interrupts Peter while reading. His autobiography reveals a rambling yet intelligent way about the miseries of his life. His autobiography reveals his inability to relate to others, including the fellow residents of his rooming house on the Upper West Side. Actually, he had a room to live. He had hired a room, not the full apartment. So this shows that the lower class person, they could not afford the whole apartment. So he used to live in a room. In a final and suicidal attempt to give his life meaning, Jerry has on this day set out intent on creating the suicidal encounter that ends a play. By impaling himself on a knife held by Peter, the paragon of the normal, Jerry at once makes contact with another human and challenges the Borgoges, the sense of Borgoges, the sense of social and moral order. So actually, this is a description about the character of Jerry. These four characters are there, which are called as the supporting characters. You can read it carefully. The landlady and the dog, the queen. These are the three characters actually, which are called as the supporting characters. In some descriptions, people are not writing about these characters. They are only discussing the two characters. One is Peter, other is Jerry. The whole play is revolving on these two characters. But these three characters, you know that they are also the part of the play. One is the landlady. The landlady, the caretaker of Jerry's room, she is caretaker of Jerry's room, a lustful, obese, ignorant and drunken woman. She likes her dog, makes unwanted advances toward Jerry. Presented is one of his narratives, she is the emblem of his disgust with humanity and the repulsiveness of his experience. She is a lady who is full-time drunken, and she wants actually many things from Jerry, and she had a dog, and that dog was killed by Jerry. Later on, Jerry poisons that dog. Another character is the dog. The dog is landlady's canine friend, the black beast with a constant reaction. Cinderella and attempts to bite Jerry every time. Whenever Jerry leaves the room, whenever Jerry enters the room, the dog always attempts to bite Jerry. In an attempt to placate the monster, the Jerry feeds it hamburgers and finally poisons the dog. When the dog recovers, Jerry is strongly drawn to the now calmer animal. For a moment, he feels empathy for the dog that he has hurt. This violent love or hate foreshadows the play's final encounter between Jerry and Peter. Another homosexual person, that is the queen, a black homosexual who occupies a flat in Jerry's building. This gay man lives with his door always open, never leaving except to go. The queen is a black homosexual who occupies a flat in Jerry's building. As I told you, homosexual person is there who is always open his door, never leaving except to go to bathroom. He does nothing but model his Japanese kimono and tease his eyebrows. In Jerry's eyes, he becomes the image of an indifferent and supercilious god. So that's all about the characters. Read, listen this lecture carefully, and then inshallah in the next lecture we will talk about summary of the play. Thank you very much. Take care of yourself.